Obviously, housemates didn't hold back.
Do you want to fight?
I don't want to fight. Why would I want to fight with you? Why are you going on silly now?
I have friends on the outside world, which you maybe don't have, and I have a family that care about me.
And things turned nasty.
You're an excuse for a human being.
I know.
There's no need to get into my face.
You're in my face now.
He's a bitter, twisted old man.
Don't let him see you cry.
Well, that means stupid.
Lauren was rather upset.
I am brutal. If you was a bit more like me, maybe you'd win a few fights.
Tonight, Gary channels the spirits.
You live in a conflict zone, buddy.
I wouldn't treat people how you treat people in this house.
You are in a conflict forever because you can't get out of your own way.
Wow, that was good.
I've just started, buddy.
And a shocking double eviction.
Fourth to be evicted is Stephanie.
No,
oh, my God. Fifth to be evicted is Kelly.
Why would you be happy that she got booed?
I didn't say I was happy.
Okay.
You're lying to yourself. And you're lying to me, and that's an insult. They don't care about me like I care about them. And that's the truth, because I see it in their eyes.
Day 19, 9:42 a.m. It's eviction day. Tonight, two housemates will leave. Audley, Edel, Gary, James, Kelly and Stephanie all face the public vote. Yesterday, during the anonymous feedback task, James upset Lauren with his comments.
It's obvious how much she wants to win, but she does nothing really to help herself. She needs to start doing more around the house and stop letting everyone wait on her every demand.
I was very shocked
yeah.
when they said that you're the guy that wrote that.
Are you trying to be more interested now or something? Is that what you're trying to do? You were boring on Strictly. You
had an opportunity. No, I just thought that just showed a little bit of cowardness. You're not standing up straight away.
Brutal. I am brutal.
You are brutal. You are brutal.
Maybe if you was a bit more like me, maybe you'd win a few fights.
True.
Are James and I'll be okay?
Yeah. I think it's gone there now, though. I think that's all they have left. For each other, but... It was pretty heavy. I was just sitting there in the middle of it.
Audley has a bee in his bonnet.
This is the problem with Britain today. The kids don't want to get up. They don't want to work. They want to lay in bed.
And drink alcohol.
And drink alcohol, smoke cigarettes. This is the problem.
We need to change society.
People need to get up and they need to do work.
This is the problem with Britain today.
Well, it's not just Britain, it's youngsters in general.
Well, bloody, James ain't a youngster. George ain't a youngster. James is old enough to know better.
What's that?
We're talking about the problem with Britain today.
Yeah, I know.
Everyone having late lines. Don't get up in the morning, do a workout, eat fresh juice.
Very true. You're the man, mate. You're the man.
Ten 11 a.m. Gary is taking a moment.
Here you are again, Gary. Another day in the London Hour.
Audley is talking to Big Brother about yesterday's feedback task.
Last night, James, threw Lauren under the bus, which was very uncouth. Obviously, when James had an opportunity last night to attack me, he did. And obviously, I also attacked James. And so, although we can remain cordial, the truth of the matter is he's not really my cup of tea, which is okay. Everybody, you can't like everybody. You have to stand for something. And just James's personality and what he stands for, I find him belittling and disrespectful to women to some degree. James is trying to compete with me, and I don't know why, because I'm not trying to compete with James. There's actually no competition there. So I'm just trying to be me. And James seems to have a problem with that. And for every now and again, he has a dig. He talks about me being knocked out, or talks about boxers being dumb, or talks about, you know, my comeback being fruitless. But, you know, like I said, what he's got to say is irrelevant to me. And, you know, I wish him well in his life, and I hope he looks in the mirror and has a wake-up call and realise that what he's projecting to the universe is, I don't think, is a positive light.
George has got a question for Kelly.
Do you think that the public will be shocked to see how much you've changed from Frank to Kelly? Like in your calmness and etc. You know, I know you've lost it a couple of times and you said that, but
I actually think I was very calm yesterday.
You was?
I felt a couple of times I wanted to bite, but I thought.
I thought you would be one of the ones to bite and have an argument, and you've done really well yesterday. You really bit your lip.
The problem is that Audley and me come from a world where if you don't stand up, and it's an individual sport, we do not. You know, we make as a promoter, my decision was final, right? And I constantly had to argue with people. Audley, as a boxer, steps in that ring on his own, and he had to fight. So we are individuals. Where yeah. Where it doesn't matter what we say, because we know the world we come from, the louder you shouted, the better it was for you. What you say to us is like water off a duck's back. You know, I've been insulted by a far lot bigger and better yeah. people than you.
But it's funny because I find you and Audley are the two people I find the easiest to wind up.
But you don't wind me up no more.
Okay.
You honestly don't. You might think you do, you don't. If you wound me up, I would bite really big at you and go for you.
Coming up, Gary gets deep.
You still have love for your husband?
Yeah. I'm gonna cry.
It's okay, you can cry. It's venting, it's getting out feelings that have been held up in you.
And tempers flare.
You are in a conflict forever because you can't get out of your own way.
...12:41 PM. Big Brother has gathered the housemates for today's task.
Today, Gary will become the House Guidance Counselor.
Fire up then.
It will be Gary's task to provide housemates with guidance and help them find their inner truth on a variety of personal issues.
There you go, Gary.
If Gary completes the task to Big Brother's satisfaction, housemates will receive an award.
Yeah.
Good luck to everyone.
I think we have to go in and just talk about our own issues.
I'm going to talk about feminine issues.
Yeah, go on, please.
Big Brother has provided Gary with a calm and spiritually balanced therapy room for his counselling sessions.
Oh, my God. Where did you guys get this picture? All right.
Right, here's my scenario. Can you help me please, counsellor? I've moved into this halfway house, yeah? And one of the people I'm sharing the house with is the most rudest, ignorantest, slyest person I've ever
Hey, are you talking
across.
To me? Don't talk about me like that behind my back.
I know you're referring to the counsellor himself.
Can you advise me on how to deal with this person? Because I've been getting, like, thoughts of deep violence and...
Is that what you're going to say?
Yeah.
To begin, Gary is focusing on couple therapy, and first up is Stephanie and George.
Love this room.
What are your true emotional feelings for George?
I adore George and love him as a friend.
What's your definition of friend?
Like a brother.
Brother's blood, friends aren't.
Okay, non-sexually.
That is a friend.
Yes.
Now, George, could you explain to Stephanie what your true emotional feelings are to her?
Well, my true emotional feelings towards you is the same as yours. I think you're a brilliant friend. I think you're beautiful.
Now, I'd like for you to exchange the heart you're holding. Now, George, you're holding Stephanie's heart, and Stephanie, you're holding George's heart. You're pure in your reactions to something you like or don't like. And that's essentially great.
Oh, good.
I, observing you, have a feeling it is true. That's love. That's friendship love. Friendship love is deeper than just, I love you, love at first sight, oh my God, I can't wait to be with you. Soulmatedness. Because there's truth in there that I see.
I'm trying to push us together.
No, that's something that you're feeling in you right now. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing a thing for that. It's you that's feeling that within you. And that's the beauty about true feeling from the heart. Well, I feel really good about talking to you. Would you tell me what I have said to you? How has it made you feel?
I feel like we've... Now we don't have to prove anything to anyone.
Mm, yeah, you don't need that. Because I love you both.
And we love you too.
Love each
other.
You.
You guys, thank you. And you guys love each other both. And it's just friends now. That's okay. But that's a germophobia's way to look at it. Just keep it as friends. I don't want to get no bacteria in here.
Ricky and Lauren are next to Fierce Gary's Couples Therapy.
Okay, to start with you, Lauren.
Mm-hmm.
What are your true feelings for Ricky?
I think he's lovely. He's got a lot of respect for women. He's sweet, he's kind, and I think he's a great guy.
Okay, Ricky?
I think she's gorgeous. She's everything that I would look for in a woman. She's strong. It's just nice to be around.
Aww.
Your hearts are like this. Your hearts are like this. That works in the truth of your mind and your spirit. Anybody need to get hit in the head?
Hey!
No, I'm kidding.
Oh my God.
Oh boy.
p.m. After visiting Counselor Gary, George and Stephanie are discussing their relationship.
No, I just thought you were just going along, making the best of a situation, which I wouldn't have did. I wouldn't have been angry with you about. I just would have been gutted about.
Yeah. No, I love Georgie.
You can go off and do whatever you like, but I'd be gutted if, like, I got in contact with you and went, oh, come on, look, give me a date and we'll go out for lunch, and you turn around and go, look, George, I'm not being funny, but you know that won't happen. I'd feel like a right cock.
Yeah, but you haven't made it into a pressure issue.
I wouldn't pressure anyone.
Gary's next sessions will probe unresolved emotional issues, and Dee will be counselled first.
Dealing with the pressures of fame and life as a celebrity. That's what we're going to talk about.
Okay.
The word fame is facing a massive energy.
Yes.
Could you give me some examples on how it has been difficult for you as a celebrity?
It's been hard having been thrown into the spotlight. I wouldn't say fame. See, that fame is a funny one, isn't it, Councillor Gary? It's like...
It sure is. Comes with that warning.
You're right, it does.
Well, this bargain that you didn't expect has stifled your self-esteem.
I had low self-esteem anyway.
Get that self-esteem pump out. And mentally, spiritually, pump it back up. Boom! It won't explode, but it will carry you to heights that you haven't been before and you deserve to be.
I'm scared of heights, though.
Edel is next in to receive Gary's words of wisdom.
Can you explore with me what any negative feelings you're going through right now to hinder your movement in Big Brother?
I don't have any negative feelings towards any housemate. It's all for me. It's all within my own self.
Yeah.
With my situation, I'm going through a separation in a marriage, and it's very hard.
Okay. So you're carrying that with you in an honest, truthful, caring way.
Yeah.
The feelings you had from that are still with you now.
Absolutely, 100%.
The word past, P-A-S-T, stands for preoccupation about spent time.
Yeah.
You're living in your past, you're not moving forward.
That's right.
Do you still have love for your husband?
Yeah.
How deep is it?
I'm not gonna cry.
It's okay, you can cry. It's venting, it's getting out feelings that have been held up in you. There's nothing wrong with that. That's why we're built to cry and laugh.
Yeah.
It's a relief, it's a release.
I have a huge amount of love for him, but love has to be practical. If you're not getting on every day, and you don't feel good, and your whole family is not going to the higher vibration that we should be living in, you can't live like that.
Yeah.
I'm emotional right now.
And that's okay, that's part of living, that's part of letting go.
Yeah.
And be positive. Man, be positive. Ain't that easy to say, but sometimes so hard to do. You know?
Yeah.
One good exercise, stand up. And put your feet about as wide as your shoulders are. And then reach here and here and expand your arms as far as you can. And stay here for a while, gathering all that love that's in the universe. And then you pull the love of the universe into your heart. And you bow your head and thanks. Do that. Do that several times a day.
Thank you.
Thanks, Harry.
See you later.
Yay!
Yay.
And take, you feel good about this?
I do.
Because I really do. I'm getting a lot out of this too.
That was a bit of a real session there, kind of, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dublin, I love
you. Thank you.
Okay. Yay! That was lovely. What a lovely woman Adele is.
Oh, yeah, okay, we're playing Snog, Marry, Avoid.
Me,
George,
Ricky.
Ricky and James. Okay, so, avoid James. Really?
Uh-oh.
All right, avoid James, Snog George and marry Ricky.
Oh. Aye, that's cool, man.
It's Councillor Gary's final session of the day. Conflict resolution with Kelly, Audley and James.
We're here to talk to the three of you, and the three of you talk to each other about conflict resolution. So, Kelly, let's start with you.
Towards Audley, I have no bad feelings. James and I obviously do have a bit of conflicts, I believe. Maybe I see a bit of Frank in James, and I didn't like that side of it. Very arrogant, very aggressive. And I find James is quite dismissive of women. So some of his comments he makes, but I think that's your insecurity.
Do you have a hard time getting your feelings out in the open to James?
No, because if I've got something on my chest, I'll say it.
That is great. Okay, Audley.
Mr. James Jordan.
Oh boy.
No,
should we set up a ring?
No. The main thing is, it's like things about James, you know, rub me the wrong way, and maybe there's some things about me that rub him the wrong way. But ultimately, I'm not here to be fighting with James, attacking James. It's not. I'm not about that. I'm bigger than that.
Good. That sounds great. James, you have the floor.
These two people, I have had several occasions where we've had mixed words. I didn't know Kelly as Frank, so I just took Kelly as face value for who she was.
Yeah.
However, very quickly I saw that Kelly wasn't the nicest person in the world. She didn't take criticism very well. When she was nominated, firstly by Leslie, she kicked off, went up to the diary room, wanted to leave, had massive arguments with people. And I said before I came in here, if there's someone that I see that's not being nice to people, I'm the type of person that I will bully a bully.
Do you feel yourself as an emotional enforcement sheriff?
No, and I suppose it's not my place. However,
I was emotionally upset. I did want to leave the house, but that was only in the first week. But you keep playing the same record.
It wasn't the first week, because we weren't even up for nominations.
Okay,
quiet.
Leslie. Everybody quiet.
By Leslie.
Everybody quiet. There's no need for this. This is what's keeping the conflict alive. The conflict has got to be let go of and deceased and put out to pasture, exonerated like a raging bull in a rodeo. That raging bull, that conflict, has hurt a lot of people. Let's put it in the pasture where it doesn't ride in the rodeo anymore.
I agree.
That is
100%. The truth.
What have you done wrong that you can change?
When I grew up being a dancer, it was pretty tough. People always used to say, call lots of names. You're soft. You're this.
You still carrying that image?
No, but what I'm saying is, I learned from a very early age that I had to stand up for myself.
You're taking things personally you don't have to take.
I'm not taking it personally.
You're still carrying that.
James!
No, I'm not.
James, time out! You're taking it personally because you're still living within you.
Well, I wouldn't treat people how you treat people in this house.
Do you think people in here respect you, or do you think the audience is going to work against you?
You know what? I actually really don't mind, because I kind of, everything I've done is in this house, I can justify.
Yeah, but is it justifiable in a good way with the British public and the people's hearts you're dealing with?
I don't mind as long as my friends and family know who I am. They know who I am and
but
what I stand
by. But you
don't
care how your actions affect others.
Of course I do.
You live in a conflict zone, buddy.
You push ladies out of the way. You push ladies.
I don't push them
yes,
out
you
of
do.
The way.
Fact.
Fans, this I've is about that. You, not me.
Oh.
And you are in a conflict forever because you can't get out of your own way.
Wow, that was good.
I've just started, buddy. I can have a conversation with you in peace.
Yeah.
Or I can confront with you the way you choose to confront with others.
I didn't shout at you.
No, you didn't. But you're shouting at me in your eyes and in your mind and your stubbornness. And they see that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
They see it.
But other people
I see it.
In you.
I hear it. And I don't understand why you do it.
Okay.
Because I love you, I adore you, you're a good friend, you'll be a friend forever.
Come on, open yourself up, James. Don't be cross. That means you're defensive. Open yourself up.
This is open.
Open to the universe. Take it all in.
Ah! Understand each other. Say that.
We love and understand each other.
Yeah, we will find our inner truth in giving love.
We will find our inner truth in giving love.
How do you feel, guys?
Feel uplifted
and open,
cleansed.
Great.
Yeah, good.
I think it's cleared the air. Hopefully, that we can continue.
Yeah.
On harmonies when we
no conflict.
No conflict for the rest of the time.
We have lost the ability to have a conflict.
Gary. Guidance counseling has been magnificent. Wow.
Aloha.
Coming up, James sounds off.
I think it insults my intelligence that I'm being psychoanalyzed by someone who needs to be psychoanalyzed.
And Gary speaks up.
You're lying to me, and that's an insult, because I did not say that.
Okay.
PM. Gary's reflecting on his earlier counselling sessions.
You were hearing that, I just thought of something. I just thought of the task I just did.
Yeah. Wow.
God, thank you, my spiritual guides, for the energy I was given in that. That's beyond human energy.
Yeah, it was very good.
In my way of feeling and doing it.
It was very good. It was very helpful. It allowed us to get something off our chest without getting into an argument.
Well, good. Yeah, the mediator.
Yes, a mediation. That's it.
Mediation, yeah. James is a... He's a hard-headed little boy.
I think he's sad and lonely.
Wow. Where do you get that from?
Because of his answers. Because of his mannerism. He's always on the attack. He needs to be leader of the pack. Or he wants to be leader of the pack.
Yeah, but...
Which he will never be.
No, he won't. Not that way of leading.
No, not that way.
It's not leading. There's constant discombobulation in the pack.
James has come to the diary room.
Hello, James. How are you this afternoon?
I'm all right. I'm a bit pissed off with Big Brother, though, if I be perfectly honest.
What's wrong?
What's wrong? Well, I'll play any game. You know, I'll do what I signed up for. However, you put me in a room with, in my opinion, two mentally unstable, one deluded person in the house. The only three people in this house that I've had run-ins with, and it was kind of everyone against James, which I think is unfair because I could have told you that was going to happen before I went in there. I think it insults my intelligence that I'm being psychoanalyzed by someone who needs to be psychoanalyzed. You've got someone that is clearly not all there, talking about things that Big Brother knows are not necessarily just for fun, and they're telling me about myself. I've never been on therapy. I'm quite happy with my family, my marriage, my the way I live my life. I've got my friends. I support people. I'm a good person. I raise money for charity. I do lots of good things in the world. And it's three against one. And I just thought that was slightly unfair.
You still haven't explained what's insulted you specifically.
So what do you not understand, Big Brother? I told you what insulted. I think that it was unfair that you put me in a room with the three people that I have had problems with.
It was a conflict resolution session, James.
It was a conflict resolution session where the person who was trying to resolutionize everybody, I have an issue with. Why am I'm going to listen to someone who says you have to respect your elders? You earn respect, you don't demand respect. It comes over time. You don't just get respect like this because you're, what, Gary Busey, the Hollywood superstar? No. You have to earn my respect.
PM. The housemates are preparing for tonight's eviction.
Who do you reckon tonight, then?
I still do reckon, possibly, James and Kelly.
James and Kelly?
A double. They've had the two worst crowd reactions. But obviously, I still live in hope that Mr. Boosie goes.
He told me he's not going anywhere tonight.
He's not?
I go, are you worried about being evicted tonight? And he goes, I'm not going anywhere.
How are you feeling about tonight?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah?
I'm easy either way.
Yeah.
It's been good fun, it's been a good experience, you know what I mean? So it's been good.
Mad experience, but...
Yeah. It's been good.
Good.
When you start packing, you get really excited.
Mm.
Like, really excited.
I definitely have a bit of excitement in me.
Yeah.
You know, even though I would like to stay, I feel like I could definitely benefit from being here for a little bit longer, but... The idea of going excites the crap out of me.
Oh, excuse me. I've got butterflies.
Really?
I don't know. Yeah, just come on.
My worst case scenario is if James and Ida leave and I stay, what will I do?
I think that, honestly, I honestly believe I am the villain of the show.
Me too.
Because I stand
up
to people.
I'm a villain because you're my best friend.
Oh, all right.
You know what that means? Eviction night.
Eviction night, man.
Yay!
That's the lot, Chuck.
All right. All right.
Yay!
Celebrity Big Brother house, this is Emma.
Hi, Emma.
Hi, Emma.
Audley. Adele.
Hi.
Gary.
Hello.
James. Kelly.
That's not too bad. It's a bit better.
Stephanie. The viewers have spoken. Your fate is sealed. I can now reveal the two housemates with the most votes and therefore safe from eviction are, in no particular order, James. James, you are safe.
You're safe?
I'm
yes,
Kim!
Well
done, Sam.
And...
Oh, come on.
I'm going.
Gary.
Oh!
Gary, you're so safe.
It's good. Yay. Thank you. Thank you.
I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes and four to be evicted is... Stephanie.
No way. What, survived another one?
I can't get it all.
I love you so much.
Oh, I love you so much.
Oh my God, yes, it's
so good.
Oh, I love you.
I love you.
have fun.
Oh my god.
Bye.
Love you, Kelly. Good luck.
It's okay. You know how
happy I am. You know. You know.
You know. Bye, Gary.
Bye, bye, honey.
All right.
Big crisis. Bye,
goodbye, everyone. Bye. Bye.
We're gonna miss you, we're gonna miss you.
I love you.
Go rock and Stephanie.
How are they they're going?
No, both.
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 There was more booze.
No, there was more cheers.
No,
there was more cheers.
I heard
no, there was more cheers.
I heard more booze.
No.
And I've got good ears.
No, I'm right. I can hear, don't forget. You can't
so
hear.
So can I can hear. Hey, yeah, come whatever. On. Hey, come on, James. James, we're trying to start
why are you
the
being
conflict.
Nasty? Why are you being nasty? She's what? Gone out. She's a lovely girl. She got more cheers.
You don't understand.
She got more cheers, man. Come on.
You don't understand
don't
what I'm saying.
So
hey, James. James, look at me. Come on.
Listen.
Give me a break.
I love that girl. She's
so
such a great
I.
girl.
It's all right. Never mind that. It's all right. Everything's okay.
Okay.
There's nothing wrong with
okay,
it.
Okay, but why would you be happy that she got booze?
I didn't say I was happy. Okay. You're lying to yourself. And you're lying to me. And that's an insult. Because okay. I did not say that.
Okay.
Coming up, Jim senses weakness.
Audley's having a round and move himself and he's chucking the elbow through.
You know the funny thing is, I bet he still gets knocked out.
And Gary opens up.
I don't think they understand me or want to understand me or think that I'm too old for this or think I shouldn't be here. I don't know.
...10:06 p.m. It's been 20 minutes since Stephanie was evicted.
Hey. Hey, guys. Adele and James,
sorry,
I
yeah.
just got hit, and she's gone for good, Stephanie.
Yeah, unfortunately.
It's quite a miss for me in my heart with what we have shared and gone through together, me and Steph.
Yeah,
it's huge for you.
I miss your presence already.
Oh, right, okay.
Because of what you
Lara, pants off her.
What's that?
Oh, yeah, you always said Lara, pants off her.
Did you understand that, Adele?
He said he misses her presence already.
Yeah.
Did you understand what I said to you?
Yeah, you missed her presence already.
I said she had a presence around the whole house.
Yeah, she did. She
it
did.
Made sense to me and a completion bond.
I'm so I don't get this.
Of a union that was legal.
I don't get that she's gone.
The British public.
Have spoken. Have spoken.
There they have, haven't they?
Here we go.
Oh!
Celebrity Big Brother house, this is Emma.
Hi, Emma.
Please take your seats on the sofa.
Sofa time.
Tonight is a double eviction.
Uh-oh.
I can now reveal the housemate with the fewest votes and fifth to be evicted is... Kelly.
Come on, Kelly, you go out and show them how it's done.
Well done. Good luck, be strong, okay?
Right, listen, you show them how it's done. Listen. All right?
You okay now?
Feeling the outside, yeah?
You look amazing, by the way.
Yeah. You be strong.
I could try.
Kelly.
Very strong.
Big up. Yeah? Big up.
Good job.
Be strong. Hey, Kelly. Be strong now, yeah?
Go Kelly!
Be strong now, Kelly!
Go get him, girl! You got him, Kelly!
Remember, you made a tough stop.
Oh, she needs it, though, the support more than anyone.
There's some cheers.
Yeah, there's loads of cheers.
Yeah. Oh, they've gone! Grand Cam, Grand Steph!
Love you, Steph.
So one, two, three, four, five, six gone. Six down, eight left.
She'll be fine. She'll see her little dogs now. She'll see her daughters, speak to her mum. She'll go back to the license.
Yeah.
Get done. 10:45 p.m. James and Gary are reflecting on tonight's evictions.
So how do you feel?
I'm okay.
You're okay?
I'm okay. I was mentally prepared to go. You knew that.
No, you didn't tell me.
But you said you could see I was thinking I was going to go.
You, no, I didn't know whether you think you were going to go. I'm thinking you were in such unknown water that you didn't know what to think. You know, like, am I going to go? Am I not? It's a question you have with yourself that reads in your face.
Yeah.
That's what I picked up.
Audley and Edel are unpacking in the bedroom.
I really thought I was going. It's quite nice to survive one.
Yeah. To go through that experience and survive it.
Yeah. It's quite nice.
Yeah.
But I really thought I was going. I'm not joking. I'm really, it's a little odd to be.
Shit, you got your fans, man. You got your fans.
Yeah, that's nice.
I mean, Stephanie probably doesn't have a crap base. And once they probably gave up that the relationship wasn't real, that probably sealed the deal.
And then she made friends with Gary as well, you see.
Yeah.
There wasn't that to watch anymore.
I think Adele becomes the temptress now, so, you know.
Oh, yeah, there's still time.
This is it. What, mate? Yeah, you're straight in there, don't worry about that. What do you mean with me? Too right. Hey, listen, this is all part of the long con, don't forget that.
James has come to the diary room.
Hello, James.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Gutted to hear that people are going, get James out, get James out, get James out. I'm so confused at the moment in this house. People are booing for me, but I'm staying. There's people in here which I think are amazing people, and they're leaving. So I don't know what I'm doing right for people to be saving me. I really don't know. I mean, it's literally like, is it flicking a coin? I don't know. I'm still here. I'm still going to try and be myself as much as I possibly can. Yes, it's a game. And I only kind of played the game once and it backfired on me, so I won't do that again. So I'm going to be true to myself like I was before. I do believe I'm the most honest person in this house. And I do believe myself to be a really strong character. I really do. I believe that I'm a stronger character than nearly everyone in this house. But that is still hard to handle. And no one has had it to the extent that I have. Even if I won the show and I walked out to booze, Yeah, you've won because people dislike you. That's weird. I always said, I don't give a shit what people think about me. But this journey has made me realise that I actually do. I do care. And I, for 36 years, for my whole life, I've said I don't care what people think about me. But I actually do.
p.m. Audley is working out. In the pool, James and Edel are talking about Audley.
It's going to be easier for me now that at least one of that duo's gone.
Yeah.
Because it was kind of two against one.
So much. And yeah. I think Audley
is kind of now. I can see a big difference in him already.
Yeah, he's down as well.
Definitely.
Yeah.
He's got no one to back him up and go, haha, that's really funny.
Yeah.
Lauren has a big question for George.
Did I think Ricky?
Shut up!
Has he got a small willy? Well, I've got a small willy, but I don't. Oh, I do it.
Yeah.
I've
never seen him.
All right, well, I'll try and find out whether he's got a big willy.
No, please don't, because I actually don't want to
I know. Do find it a little bit strange that he still gets, because like, you can't, like, I'm not being funny, like, the reason why I'm not embarrassed is because I suppose it's because I've not had no complaints.
I'm used to a proper boy.
Oh, proper bit of meat.
No, I mean, like, whatever. Like, now, you'll be confident around it, like I'm confident in my body. Nothing's perfect, but...
You're saying you're fancy me, Lauren? Is that what you're saying? What? Just because I'm at one with my body, you want me?
Oh,
I think you should ask him out, right?
No.
I'm going to go in the living room, I think you should ask him.
Ricky! Ricky!
Hey, look!
Audley, I'm in the mirror with myself.
Huh? Audley's having a round in the room with himself, yeah. And he's chucking the elbow through.
You know the funny thing is, I bet he still gets knocked out.
AM. Ricky and Dee are horsing around.
In your face hole. Hugs and kisses. Sweet dreams.
Ricky!
Oh yeah, I just rocked your world.
God, you're a super stud.
I'll walk it off.
You know that.
You know that.
Gary is talking to Big Brother.
I feel great because it's just wonderful to be loved and included and respected in a way that you don't get that much in the house. Excuse me.
Do you think your housemates were glad you were saved?
No, I don't think so. I think when James was saved, everybody jumped up and clapped, and they're all British people. When I was saved, it was like a few people clapped, and I didn't feel any care from them at all. I just don't feel it. I don't feel love and affection toward me from them. I don't feel it at all. And I want to feel it, and I want to give it to them, which I am. But boy, stubborn. And I don't understand a lot of the humor. I don't understand some things and have to say, what was that again? What did they say? And it's starting to, I guess, wearing very thin on them. And they don't care about me like I care about them. And that's the truth, as I see it in their eyes. I don't think they understand me or want to understand me or think that I'm too old for this or think I shouldn't be here. I don't know. But it didn't hurt my feelings. It was good for me that I was saved by the British public. That's what counts. Not the clapping, not the adoration, not the yay. You see how I reversed that? I came around to understanding the truth of what it is when people clap. And then, on top of that, understanding the truth of what it is when the British public saves you. And that's the truth. God bless you guys and you girls, young and old. I love the Brits.
Tune in to Bit on the Psych at 11:15 when latest evictees Stephanie and Kelly will join Rylan in the studio.